Every network is striving to improve DCR KPI, and it has become more important in LTE since the introduction of OLTE. In simple words, call drop means that a user's ongoing session is dropped. Hi, my name is Sanjay Singh. I'm working as an RF engineer. Today, I'm going to discuss more about LTE, OLTE, DCR optimization. In this video, I will cover some important parametric optimization through case study. To understand in detail, DCR optimization is divided in some parts, and each part contains some parameter tuning. So let's discuss one by one.
So to improve the drop call rate of any of the network, configuration check is very, very important. In this video, I covered the parameters that belongs to the Nokia equipment only. Maybe I will cover other vendors parameter in some other video. So site configuration checks has been divided in three parts. First one is RET checks. Second one is antenna RTT, and third one is cross feeder. So let me go one by one. This one is the RET check. So under the RET check, first thing you have to check, RET should be defined for each of the sectors. And second thing you have to check, there should be no alarm. Like this site contains motor jam alarm and we cannot change the RET value. Also, we don't know how it is behaving, so maybe the chance it impacting the drop calls. So in such cases, we have to contact to the field engineers for the correction. Next one is antenna RTT. RTT is round trip time delay between the E-node B port and the antenna. So we have to be sure this value is correct for your site or not. To check this value, we have to log into BTS manager. In the BTS manager commissioning file part, there is the options antenna. Under the antenna, you can find the RTT delay. This is the value, RTT delay. So if it is not correct, then it calculated by the E-node B, and if it is not correct, then it will impact accessibility and retainability both KPI. It should be always as per the design. If you don't have the value, you can check with the design team and you can use the same value for this parameter. Let me show you some results. If this value is not as per the design, then what will happen? So see here, someone mistakenly changed the RTT value from 20 to very higher value. Then what happened? Reach success rate degraded from 90% to just less than 10%. And once we corrected the same, you can see all the reach success rate is recovered. So one KPI that is very impacting reach success rate from the RTT incorrect value, and user experience are very, very bad. Like user can one way audio observed after the timer expiry, and multiple complaints you can find related to no audio issue in some places where you did change, or if mistakenly something wrong value for the RTT. Other KPI is also degraded due to the RTT, like we are talking today for the DCR. So drop rate is also impacting. You can see here ERAP drop rate is degraded in the same period when RTT value was incorrect, and it impacts the handover KPI as well. So RTT value is very, very important to improve the DCR, handover performance, and ERAP drop. You can see here after correcting the RTT, site came back to normal performance, reach improved, and our performance improved, ERAP drop improved, RDO issue also resolved. Third thing is the cross feeder. So cross feeder, it is also called the swap. So this one is the PCI plot. In the PCI plot, see this sector is blue and this one is the pink. In front of the blue, we are getting the pink color, and in front of the pink, we are getting the blue color. So it does mean here sector swap between this sector and this sector. If it happen in your network, there is the huge call drop you can find because of the wrong neighbor. So to find the swap, you have to collect the drive data from the drive test team. And if you don't have this data, then also you can check this cross feeder swap with the help of the handover report. In the handover report, first sector, suppose this is the first sector, so first sector always gives the maximum handover to the cell who are serving in front of that. But if in the report you can see first sector not giving the handover to this site, it gives the handover to this site area very high numbers count, then definitely there may be the chance of the swap. Same thing for the second sector as well. Second sector give maximum handover to this site area cell where it not serving. So this way you can identify the swap without the drive report.
So once you finish the site configuration check for the RET, for the RTT and cross feeder check, you have to move on the second part, that is the parameter audit. Parameter audit is very important for the any of the network optimization, and it is especially important for the DCR optimization. So parameter optimization itself a very big part. So I'm not considering whole parameter audit in this video, but I will create a separate video for this. As you know, parameter audit can be done by some micro, by some tool, or manually. It depends on the your organization or your operator. So here I will show you some results where we did some parameter change, and after that we get good improvement in the OLTDCR KPI. So you can see here earlier OLTDCR KPI was near 0.5 and now it came down to 0.2 after changing the parameter. So we change here DRX profile index, that is the LNBTS MO class parameter. We change it from 2 to 1. After that, we found a good improvement in the OLTDCR. And second parameter that belongs to the LN cell MO class. And this is the uplink improved latency reaction timer. We change it from 200 millisecond to 5 millisecond, and we found improvement in the OLTDCR from 1.4 to 1.3 now. So these are the two parameters which you can try in your network. So we completed site configuration checks and parameter audit. Now third part is for the PCI collision check for the OLTDCR optimization. So PCI collision is very, very important for network. Let me tell you how you have to check it and how it impact the drop call rate. So suppose this is the site, and this site, this sector having the PCI X, and if any of the neighbor site that serving towards this sector, either this one, either this one, having the X PCI, it means we have the PCI collision. So what will happen, drop call rate will be increased for this area. This is the KPI you can see here. Due to the PCI collision, OLT drops was nearby the 35, and after the retune, the PCI drop came to 5 now, and drop rate earlier 7 and now it came to nearby 1.5. So this is the good improvement in the drop call rate after the PCI change. This one is the second example in which what happens, a new site came in the area, and for new site PCI was incorrect, or you can say the PCI was used for the neighbor site PCI as was already used, so due to which drop call was increased. And now after changing the PCI, it came back to normal. So till now we have completed the site configuration checks, parameter checks, and PCI collision checks. Now fourth part is the physical RF optimization for the LTE, OLTE, DCR, KPI improvement. So in the physical RF optimization, normally we are checking the RET, mechanical tilt, antenna height orientation, or you can say the azimuth. So these parts are very important for the physical RF optimization. So let me show you here with the help of the some example. Suppose there is the bunch of the sites, and each of the area are covered by the multiple sites. Some sites are overlap, some area are overlapping very huge, and some area will be maybe the coverage hole. So we have to check with the help of the drive test report, from the SINR report, from the PCI and RSRQ report, we have to check which cell is overshooting and which cell is undershooting. Based on that, we have to go for the down tilt of that cell. Also, if required, then you have to go for the azimuth change of any of the cell. If RET value is not sufficient to dominate the cell, or you can say to reduce the overshooting, you can change the parameter, that name is DLRS boost. So you can change it either in negative, either in the positive value. If you want to increase the boost, then go for the positive. If site is overshooting, then go for the negative value. So this is the basic physical RF optimization. You have to make your decision based on drive reports and call events and all, whatever you have, you can consider. Also, if you have the tools, or you can go for the report, TA sample report. So based on the TA sample report, you can check how long your cell is serving. So that will help if you don't have the drive report. We have completed site configuration check, parameter audit, PCI collision, and physical RF optimization. Now next part is mobility optimization. So mobility means handover, and handover is very, very important for any of the drop call rate improvement. So in Nokia system, I will tell you how to identify the neighbor relations are bad and how to improve your handover success rate. So first, this is the example. You can see earlier handover success rate was nearby the 92. At that time, drop call rate was nearby 1.2. Once handover success rate improved, it came now around 97. So you can see DCR also improved. Now it is around 0.8 or 0.9. So from this picture, you can see by improving the handover success rate, DCR will improve automatically. So here, this is the Nokia reports RSLT031 neighbor handover analysis report. In this report, you can find the counter, that is late handover or early handover. So first thing you have to check, your neighbor relation is failing from which cell, and if that cell belongs from the very far location, then you have to blacklist that cell. But if the case that cell is from very close to your site, then you have to identify fails are coming under which counter, it is in late or it is in early handover. Based on that, you have to make the further decision. So there is a parameter, that name is cell individual offset. It ranges minus 24 to 24. or if your handovers fails peg under the early handover. Early handover, it means what we understand. Handover fails because of early handover. If these handovers become later, then maybe the chance handover will success. So we have to convert the early handover in the later handover. How we can do it? So suppose if our network CIO value is 15, then we have to go in the negative, like we have to go in the negative 15 to 12 or 9. If you reduce the CIO value, handover which are becoming early, that become little bit late. So if it become little bit late, then requirement will fulfill and handover success rate will improve. If handover fails peg under the late handover, then we have to do something so that handover become little bit early, so that it becomes successful. So here we have to change the CIO value to positive side. So if we change this value from 15 to 18 or 18 to 21, we are going to positive side. It means whatever handover become late, that will become little bit early. So handover will success. Also, you can understand this thing. If you are going the positive side CIO, then what will happen? Traffic move to neighbor side. Here we are going to positive side. Traffic move to neighbor side. So early handover toward that neighbor. So whatever the handovers earlier become late, that now converted in the early handover. Or you can say that will be normal. Not be early, it will be the normal. And same thing for the this one negative, if you go for the negative value. And this parameter name is handover allowed. You can put it 0 or 1. 0 means it work, and if you put 1, it means it is blacklisted. So till now we already covered multiple things, multiple parameter changes. Let's recall first before proceeding in the miscellaneous check. So site configuration check. In the site configuration check, we check RET value should not be missing and there should be no alarms related to RET or motor gen. And RTT value should be correct as per the design. And in the parameter audit, we showed here two parameters change, how it impact the DCR KPI. For other parameters checks, I will prepare another video. Third one is the PCI collision checks. PCI should not be same with the neighbor site, that we should have to verify. Fourth one is the physical RF optimization. In the physical RF optimization, we change so many things like the RET, azimuth, DLRS boost parameter to reduce the overshooting or undershooting cells. And mobility optimization. In the mobility optimization, we change the parameter cell individual offset for the early and delay handover. And we blacklisted the cell in the mobility optimization for cells who are overshooting from very far location. Now we are coming to the miscellaneous checks. So miscellaneous checks, we have to verify there should be no alarm in your source site as well in the neighbor site. Next thing, cell should not be sleeping cell and there should be no RTWP issue. So what does mean the sleeping cell? Let me tell you. So in the sleeping cells, what will happen? Cell availability will be 100%, but traffic will be zero. And this problem comes due to the software or hardware issue. So sleeping cell can be resolved after the site reset. See here, once we reset the site, it start taking the traffic. And next one is the RTWP. RTWP, it means receive total wideband power. It is generally show the interference. RTWP is the level of noise within the frequency band of any cell, or you can say the uplink interference. So See here, earlier RTWP value for antenna 1 was -100, now it came to 0. At the same time, OLTE drop rate is increased from 1% to now it came to nearby 20 or 10%. This is the thing which will impact to multiple KPI like throughput, access failure, and drop. But here I'm discussing about the drop call optimization. So that is the reason I'll show you the drop call optimization. So this was the Nokia based LTE, OLTE, DCR parametric optimization. In next video, I will discuss other KPIs or other vendor parameters. If you like this video, please share and subscribe the channel. Thank you for watching.